Hi, this is code in merge sort in Kotlin. I assume you're familiar with merge sort, but if you're not, you should still be fine. Let's start by writing a test with some trivial examples. Empty list is a sorted list, so if we do merge sort, then it should be equal to an empty list. List of one is also a sorted list, so if we do merge sort, it should be equal to list of one. And merge sort will be an extension function on the list interface. Obviously, if we run this test now, it will fail because merge sort is not implemented, but we can make this test pass by just returning the original list. For the next test, let's sort list of two elements. So let's say we have list of one and two, we do merge sort, and it should be equal to list of one and two. This assertion will pass, but if we swap the elements, list of one and two will fail. Just for now, let's implement something simpler than merge sort. So if the size of the list is less than or equal to one, it's a sorted list. If the first element in the list is less than or equal to the second element, it is also a sorted list. Otherwise, we can reverse elements in the list and it will become sorted. We also need to make type parameter comparable. This test is passing now, so let's write one more test to sort list of three elements. So you can see the assertion is failing, so we should probably implement something more like an actual merge sort. So let's say we have a function merge, which will merge left and right half of the current list. So this is left half, this is right half. And the function will take left list, which we assume is sorted and right, and will return one list, which is merged. So when left is empty, we can just return right. And when right is empty, we can just return left. Otherwise, we need to choose the smallest element from left or right. So if the smallest element is on the left, we wrap it into a list and can recursively call merge. We need to drop one element from the left because it's been already processed. Otherwise, we choose element from the right and we drop one element from the right. We also need to make type parameter comparable. The assertion is passing now. However, if we add one more permutation, this assertion should fail. The problem here is that 3 and 2 become the right half of the list, and 3 and 2 is not a sorted list. So we need to call merge sort recursively for the right half, and we also need to do it for the left half, but let's not do it for the left half until we have a failing assertion. So the test is passing now, so let's add all other permutations. All the tests are passing, so we need one more test, I guess, for elements. Let's say we have list of 1, 2, 3, 4. I will not hard code all the permutations and will use a function. So for each permutation, we do merge sort and we expect it to equal to list of 1, 2, 3, 4. This test is failing now, so let's uncomment merge sort and see if it helps. And it does help. So these tests are great, but they only test using the data we could come up with. It might be useful to test against random data, so let's have a test called random sort random list. And we'll have random list with size range between 0 and 100 and values range between 0 and 100. Have relatively small values range so that we can get duplicates sometimes. And if we do merge sort, we expect list to be sorted. Where is sorted will be an extension function defined locally in the test. It's quite simple. We'll have a rolling window of size 2, and for each pair in the window, the first element must be less than or equal to the second. This is pretty much the definition of sorted list. All the tests are passing. However, if we specify slightly bigger size range, we are likely to get an error. Before we look into it, let's log down the behavior by specifying seed for the random. And the test failing, so let's look at the failure. As you can see, it is caused by stack overflow. So we basically call merge sort too many times. And this happens because we call merge as many times as many elements we have in the list. We could fix it by rewriting it in a tail recursive way, but it might be better to just rewrite it in an iterative way. So let's rename this merge into merge recursive and do another implementation, which will say return result, which will be an array list of elements. And we'll have two indices I and j. I will be indexed for the left, so while I is less than left size and j is left less than right size, we want to choose the smallest element. So if the current element on the left is less than or equal to the current element on the right, then we choose element from the left. Otherwise, we choose element from the right half. And this will be min element, which we want to add to the result. After doing the while loop, we might still have some elements remaining in the left right half, so we need to add them to the result. So let's say remaining elements in the left will be from I to left size, and we need to add elements from the right half. So this is iterative implementation of merge. Similar to how we rewritten merge, we could rewrite merge sort in an iterative way. So let's do it. We rename original merge sort into merge sort recursive. And here we will have a queue, which will be a linked list of lists of elements. And each element in the current list will be added to the queue wrapped as a list. And while queue size is greater than 1, we'll do merging. At the end, we'll expect queue to contain a single element, which will be the sorted list. And inside the loop, we can remove the first element from the queue and call it, let's say, left. And this will be right by removing another element. And just like we did before, we can merge left and right. Then we want to add it back to the queue. This is pretty much the whole implementation of iterative merge sort. As you can see, the trivial example assertion is failing. We can fix it by adding this condition at the top. To illustrate what's going on, might be useful to print the queue here, and let's run this test with 4 elements. So in the last example, we had list of 4, 3, 2, 1. So we wrap each element into a list, add them to the queue. Then we take the first 2 elements, merge them into a list, add back to the queue. Take the first 2 elements and add them back to the queue. And finally, take the last 2 elements from the queue and merge them into 1 list. Obviously, you should think twice before implementing merge sort on an actual project, so I'll just delete the code and use a library instead.